हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू हिस्ट्री एट इट्स बेस्ट। टुडे हिस्ट्री एट इट्स बेस्ट प्रेजेंट्स रिकंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ पास्ट फ्रॉम बिगिनिंग। दिस इज़ अ सीरीज ऑफ वीडियोस एंड आवर फर्स्ट वीडियो इज़ अबाउट बायोलॉजिकल इवोल्यूशन ऑफ अर्ली ह्यूमन काइंड और मैन काइंड। लेट्स टॉक अबाउट प्री हिस्टोरिक पीरियड। द ह्यूमन स्पीशीज रिप्रेजेंट द मोस्ट एडवांस्ड स्टेज ऑफ लॉन्ग प्रोसेस ऑफ इवोल्यूशन विच बिगैन विद फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अर्थ। सो फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अर्थ नियरली 4600 मिलियन ईयर्स अगो एंड द इमर्जेंस ऑफ अर्लीस्ट फॉर्म्स ऑफ एनिमेट मैटर और लिविंग्स वर अबाउट 35 मिलियन ईयर्स अगो, मे बी प्रोबेबली डायनासोर्स एंड अदर क्रिएचर्स। सो प्री हिस्ट्री इज अ वास्ट span of time which indicates the evolution of earth or humans. Then the biological evolution of early humankind and mankind. So as we know that the prehistoric period were lack of literary sources, no written records were there. So archaeological evidences shows that the evolution of humans. So primates and its classification is the first point. Second point is evolution of hominids. Third is two genus, Australopithecus and Homo. And then we'll talk about some approaches and theories of different scholars. Firstly, we'll talk about the classifications. First, the primates. The primates were very important in the aspect of human evolution. And these were firstly evolved evolving about 70 million years ago. For several million years ago, they evolved as competent tree dwellers, like they have prehensile hands and feet. And extensive use of forelimbs limbs were there. There were features and stereoscopic vision, etc., were designed for adaptation to an arboreal habitat, living in trees. Like they were forced to living in trees. Their adaptation was living in trees. So the survival was very important in any aspect. So let's talk about the further classifications. The prosomy was not so important in the evolution of humankind. So prosomy includes the lemurs, lorises and tarsiers, etc. The other classification was also there of prosomy. Then anthropoidea was very important. Anthropoidea was further divided into three categories or super families, we can say. So the first were old world monkeys, then second was new world monkeys, and then the evolution of homonoidea. The old world monkeys were often called Cercopithecoidea. The new world monkeys were Ceboidea, and then the homonoidea. So homonoidea were further divided into Pongidae and Hominidae. So the introduction of apes in human evolution were about 30 million years ago, according to fossils or fossil records or archaeological evidences. The Hominidae was further divided into two categories. First is genus Homo and genus Australopithecus. So let's talk about the key features. There were key features evolution of primates about 70 million years ago, and special features of primates are already mentioned. Arboreal habitat, prosomy, anthropoidea, separation of anthropoidea from prosomy about 40 million years ago, and the division of anthropoidea into super families. Three families were there: old world monkeys, new world monkeys, and most importantly, apes were important. In 30 million years ago, the humans are placed in the super family Hominidae. So Hominoidea. So then the division of Hominoidea into two superfamilies. The first is Pongidae, were usually apes. Second is Hominidae. Hominidae were human beings and extinct species of the closest ancestors of humans. So the Ramapithecus was the earliest known species of Hominidae in early 1960s in India. So the humans separated from African apes relatively recently, in 7 million years ago, according to recent research. Then there's the hominid evolution. The hominid evolution is separated, and like hominid evolution was very important in a vast long period. There were two major concepts. First is bipedalism. Second is rapid expansion in brain size. Bipedalism is very important because द इवोल्यूशन ऑफ ह्यूमन बाइपेडलिज्म बिगिन इन प्राइमेट्स अबाउट 4 मिलियन ईयर्स अगो और एज अर्ली एज 7 मिलियन ईयर्स अगो इन विद सेलेंथ्रोपस. One hypothesis for human bipedalism is that it evolved as a result of differentially successful survival for carrying food to share with group members, although there were alternative hypotheses. So there were different aspects, different concepts, but bipedalism is actually about the survival. So rapid expansion was also were also result of their bipedal locomotion because they were free hands and they can use the hand or they can adapt the they can use their hand for different works like making stone tools, making hunting, gathering, while making food with alternative sources and etc. The human species eventually developed in developed a much larger brain that of other primates. Typically, it was 1,330 cubic centimeter. In modern humans, nearly 3 times the size of the chimpanzees or gorilla brain. The cranial capacity was very important in any aspect. After a period of stasis with Australopithecus eminens and Ardipithecus, species which had smaller brains are as a result of their bipedal locomotion. So let's talk about the two genera. First is Australopithecus, second is Homo. So the Australopithecus was about 4.4 million years ago. Different type of primate emerged. The first bipedal primates are classified by paleontologists as hominids, and these first hominids had not yet developed the larger brain. Okay, so there was different features and talking about we'll talk about later on. The genus Homo was very important in that aspect because genus Homo was important in the evolution of humankind because the humans were also categorized in Homo. So Homo sapiens were the modern humans. Evolutionary aspect to understand which are Homo sapiens. So let's talk about the things, some theories and approaches on the biological evolution of human. First is Darwinian view, like Charles Darwin, their two books, The Origin of Species and The Descent of Man. So the Darwinian view was that the both features like bipedalism and rapid expansion in brain size had evolved similar in the same way. Or if you can say that they were at the same time, bipedalism and rapid expansion were there. So Sir Wilder Edward Lee Gross, Sir W. E. Gross, so he actually observed that the size of brain is certainly the distinctive feature of humans. It was not the distinctive feature of hominidae vis-a-vis pongidae. So that was the point of Clark. So in 1924 Raymond Dart discovered the first Australopithecus africanus fossil, an extinct hominid closely related to humans. Louis and Mary Leakey, the couple, found Australopithecus remains in Tanzania at sites located in the Olduvai Gorge. Let's more talk about the theories. The Swedish botanist Linnaeus was very important because classification it made easier to perceive differences and similarities between various species. So his classification was very important in that aspect. The Lamarck theory made a central point that plant and animal species underwent change. The species were not fixed but could change from generation to the next. So this was very important in every aspect. Let's talk about the refutes. The debates. The Stephen Jay Gould's view is that while there were long periods when almost no change took place, there were short phases where there were a burst of evolutionary activities. And the Richard Dawkins refuted Gould's argument, and he said there are several ways in which gaps in fossil can be explained. The most obvious is that a small group could have got separated from the main population and might have started evolving in isolation. The isolation theory was given by Richard Dawkins. let's more talk about the video second. Our second video is about Stone Age, the Paleolithic, Mesolithic, and we'll talk about Neolithic ages. And thanks for watching our video. Subscribe to History at its Best, like, share, और हाँ, बेल आइकन दबाना ना भूलें ताकि सारी नोटिफिकेशन सबसे पहले आपको मिले. और अगर आपको इस वीडियो में कोई भी बात समझ में नहीं आई, इवन इफ़ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस क्वेरीज, यू कैन कमेंट डाउन इट बिलो. थैंक्स.